This week's general election is in the books, but as the voter numbers creep out, it looks like Tuesday was a down year for voter participation in Vigo County.
News 10's Matt Gregory wonders, did the county's new voting system stifle votes? He investigates in tonight's Election Watch 10.
Vigo County's first general election with the new voting centers. The results, well, mixed.
They sent mailers out telling people where they could go vote and that they were able to vote anywhere. And I don't know how you get that point across.
Plenty of space in the VFW, but hour-long lines at the supermarket.
We put these in high traffic locations, hoping that people would turn in and go vote. Trying to determine when a person's going to go vote, I don't know.
Crockett says they saw more early voting than before, but not enough. That mad rush to the polls creating voter jams, like traffic jams, but just folks looking to fulfill their civic duty. Here's an interesting fact for you from Tuesday. In the Wabash Valley, three counties had turnouts below 40%, highlighted here. Vigo and Clay both used voting centers, and Vigo County's turnout was a meager 28%, down from 40% in both 2010 and 2006.
We didn't have super high-profile races in this election, so I'm sure that was probably, we had no question on the ballot, so that didn't drive people out.
In 2006 and 2010, those midterm elections also had a U.S. Senate race on the Vigo County ballot. Regardless, Crockett says the election board will take what they can learn from this year and get the vote out for next year, just not all in one day and not all at one voting center. In Terre Haute with Chief Photojournalist Mike Latta, Matt Gregory, News 10.
Vigo and Clay counties were two of 19 counties that ran voting centers in Indiana this election year.